Hello, this is Dr. Edward Park of Recharge Biomedical Clinic, and I'm recording the video accompanying my blog posting of October 3rd, 2010, regarding telomeres and telomerase. As many of you know, the Nobel Prize in Medicine was awarded to three doctors, Blackburn of UCSF, Grider of Johns Hopkins, and Shostak of Harvard Medical School for their discovery of, quote, how chromosomes are protected by telomeres and the enzyme telomerase. This shows chromosomes with their ends called telomeres. Telomeres are repeating sequences of DNA, non-coding sequences, which act to protect the tips of the chromosomes from being recognized as damaged and from being mangled by the cell's very active DNA repair mechanisms. It does so by looping back at the 3' end and forming a little circle. So, as we recall, DNA is linear. It runs from 5' all the way down to 3' in this direction, and the matching strand, which is dictated by this sense or 5' to 3' leading strand, runs in the opposite direction and runs from 5' to 3'. Anyway, the importance here is that this leading strand is being lengthened 6 base pairs at a time by this engine. This is the telomerase enzyme, which is shown here lengthening the purple by TTAGGG, 6 at a time. It does this because on this green RNA template, the message is AATCCC. Just as in the old school dimo label maker, telomerase has just 4 letters, ACGT, but that's enough to encode all living things on this planet. So if the template is this plastic letter and the DNA telomere is this green tape, the shape of the letters on the plastic dimo label maker will dictate what the spelling of the message is. Now, the reason we know this is all true is because of the Nobel Prize winners. And what's shown here is a typographical error, which was induced by this gentleman, Bill Andrews, who is shown here running his 100-mile marathons at the spry young age of 50. Dr. Andrews quite brilliantly induced a point mutation on the RNA template, which produced a typographical error in the telomeres, proving without a doubt exactly which 6 RNA base pairs were printing out the 6 telomere sequences. So, why is this important? Well, again, the tips are protected by telomeres, and having protected tips allows you to have these massive DNA libraries. What's the alternative? Well, bacteria have simple circular DNA, which, although there is a sense and an antisense strand, can be copied quite easily, like 2 soap bubbles forming from 1. No problem there. The problem is that bacteria, shown here, are all the same. They're these tiny single cell, very efficient, but not very ambitious critters that don't have a huge library in their nucleus, like eukaryotes. Eukaryotes figured out a way to protect the DNA libraries of chromosomes in the center nucleus, and the differential expression of this huge library allows for a single fertilized egg to become a house cat. And for that matter, Eukaryotic specialization allows for amoebas, slime molds, fungi, plants, and all these other things. So what is the message that's being printed out? Well, the message varies. For vertebrates, which are animals with a backbone, it's TTHGGG. But for plants, it's 7 base pairs, TTTAGGG. And for the common yeast infection, Candida albicans, it's actually 23 letters repeated over again. 23 there, 23 here, and 23 repeating base pairs on the telomeres. This just proves that telomeres are important for all living things, plants and animals, because they protect the tips. One of the plants which has the greatest telomerase activity is the bristlecone pine. And here's a wonderful example. This tree they call Prometheus. Its location is undisclosed, but it is over 4,800 years old. Now, you may not want to live that long, but now that we have TA65, a single molecule telomerase activator derived from this astragalus plant and shown to activate telomerase, we're able to sustain our stem cells and sustain our genetic integrity for much longer than previously thought. If you want to learn more, please sign up for the blog at Recharge Biomedical Clinic. This is Dr. Ed Park explaining telomeres and telomerase, and I thank you for your attention.